بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. سبحانك اللهم لا إله إلا أنت لا إله إلا أنت
that we have certainly created man into hardship, meaning that the people, the human being, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created him such that he will face difficulties and calamities throughout his life. And today we see that we are currently in the pandemic, and we see that in the UK 500 lives just went in one day. And throughout the world till now, over 1 million people have died. So this is a very difficult time that we are going through. We have never seen something like this before. So we need to even more is a need for us to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we can only plead to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to relieve us from our agonies and lift the distress. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our protector, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir, is the possessor of all power. So we cannot solve any difficulties, any issues by clinging to anything else, and at the same time returning our backs to the Quranic way and the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the only way is to follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to follow the guidance of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because if we turn our backs away, then there is no one else we can turn to. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ لِنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ. That no difficulty comes upon people except that it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who had written it is going to happen, and it is a taqdeer, and it is going to happen. And then Allah says, بَقَدَ هُوَ مَوْلَانَا, He is our Lord, our Creator, our Sustainer. So what does he say then? وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ. So those people, what should we do? We should turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and put our whole trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what we need to do primarily is to resolve to no one except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all sincerity, with full truthfulness of our heart, with all eagerness and fear, and humble ourselves from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prayer and dua. So the whole ummah, as a whole, the communities, societies, groups, individuals, we have no hope of surviving any calamity, and have no hope for deliverance from any affliction until we come to realize that deliverance from our difficulties cannot come from anyone apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He is the one whom we should invoke at every time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, قُلْ مَنْ يُنَجِّيكُمْ مِنْ ظُلُمَاتِ الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ تَدْعُونَهُ تَضَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَةً لَئِنْ أَنْجَانَا مِنْ هَٰذِهِ لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that who shall rescue from the darkness of the land and sea? That when you come upon difficulty in this world, then who is the one who is going to rescue you? And then he says, تَدْعُونَهُ تَضَرُّعًا وَخُفْيَةً. You humbly and secretly, you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you say to him, لَنْ يُصِيبَنَا لَإِنْ أَنْجَانَا مِنْ هَذِهِ لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الشَّاكِرِينَ. That you turn to Allah and you pray and beg Him and say that most surely, if you save us from this difficulty, then we will definitely be from those who are grateful. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلِ اللَّهُ يُنَجِّيكُمْ مِنْهَا. And say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will rescue you from this difficulty that you are facing. وَمِنْ كُلِّ كَرْبٍ, and every other difficulty that you face, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will also rescue you from it. But then He says, ثُمَّ أَنْتُمْ تُشْرِكُونَ, yet the prescribed partners of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This was ayat which was revealed in regards to the mushrikeen, that when they would be in difficulty, they would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I will relieve you from all difficulties, but after, instead of being thankful to me, instead of turning to me, instead of relying on me even more, what do you do? You turn your back after the difficulty. So today we are facing this time. Alhamdulillah, we are turning towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then what happens when this difficulty goes away? Will we keep on turning our backs? Will we turn our backs? Or will we keep on turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So as Muslims, we should have firm belief in our hearts of this tawheed and iman which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with, which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, that it's only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who we can turn to. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَمَّا يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ, that is He not the best one who responds to the desperate one? إِذَا دَعَى when he calls him. So who is the best person to call to? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not the best one to respond to the desperate ones when they call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَيَجِفُ السُّوءُ and he removes the evil from them. وَيَجْعَلُكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ and Allah is saying that he is the one who made you the inheritors of the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala broke us down on this earth and then he says, أَيْلَاهُ Allah. Is there any deity apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So this shows the connection between our belief in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and also our belief and iman that any time of difficulty, who should we turn to? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he is the one who has created us and he is the one who has placed us on this earth as the inheritors of this earth. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ little do you take heed or do you pay attention. So we don't turn toward these things as much. Rather here, this is the most important thing that we need to turn to. Awf ibn Malik, he came to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said that some people have arrested and have kidnapped my son, Salim. So your son Salim was kidnapped by some people and his mother is very anxious and she wanted to know that what can we do in times like this, that our son has been kidnapped in time of a difficulty. So then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ordered them to recite La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. What is it? That there is no strength, no power but with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So turn your focus to who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are going through a pandemic, turn your focus to who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he said to them to say La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah abundantly. And they complied with the order and they recited it in so much abundance and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it produce the desired effect. And one day the captors, they became unmindful and the boy managed to escape, and not only escape, what did he do? He brought a huge herd of goats with him that belonged to them, to his father. So what did he only escape but brought a lot of wealth back with him? And one narration mentions there were 4,000 sheep that he brought back with him. So not only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed him then from the difficulty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted them even more. Why? Right? Because of this. And after this incident, on that occasion, this verse was revealed. وَمَنْ يَنْتَقِ اللَّهَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. And whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whoever has done with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make his matters easy for him. And another verse reminds me as well, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. And the one who has taqwa and fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with always conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove difficulty, وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ, and Allah will also grant him provision from ways that he does not even know. So this is what we understand from this. And one day Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he began to read this verse, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِ يُسْرًا. And he kept on repeating this verse, that whoever has taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will make his matters easy for him. And he kept on repeating and repeating and repeating. And the narrator, he mentions that, the narrator mentions that the Prophet repeated this verse so much that I began to feel sleepy. And then he says to the Prophet Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, he says, that over, if all people chose only this verse, then this would be sufficient for them. So just this one verse would be sufficient. And sufficient in this report means that it would be sufficient for all those people who accomplish their religious and worldly objective if they practice upon this verse. So we need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and delegate our afflictions to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the Almighty. To Nuh alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about him, وَنُوحًا إِذْ نَادَى مِنْ قَبْلُ فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ فَنَجَّيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ مِنَ الْقَرْبِ الْعَظِيمِ. And he says that, remember Nuh alayhi salam, Allah is reminding us that when he called, meaning he called to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for help, Allah says, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ, we responded to him, وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْقَرْبِ, and we saved him and his family, وَأَهْلَهُ, and we saved him and also his family from the terrible agony. And what was that? The first which they went through. And we look at another time when وَذَكُورْ إِذْ ذَهَبَ مُغَاضِبًا فَظَنَّ أَنْ لَنْ نَقْدِرْ عَلَيْهِ فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ أَلَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. And not forget the man of the fish. Who is the man of the fish? What prophet is it? Who prophet? Yunus alayhi salam. Yunus alayhi salam is called the man of the fish, that when he left the city without being given the word from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him to be thrown overboard into the sea and swallowed by a huge fish. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions and says that, and do not forget the man of the fish, when he went off in anger and thought that we would not correct things for him, because he was angry with them, but these people are not going to change, so he left them. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it such that a wait for him. And then in the darkness of the belly of the huge fish, Allah says, and he called out within the darkness, أَلَّا إِلَّا إِلَّا أَنْتَ سُبْحَانَكَ إِنِّي كُنْتُ مِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ. There is no deity except you, Allah. You are the exalted. You are indeed, I have been from those who are the wrongdoers. So we need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and read La ilaha illa anta subhana inni kuntu min al-talibin. Once one person came to Hazrat Mawlana Yusuf ji, Hazrat Mawlana Yusuf rahmatullah alayhi, and said to him that I am reciting this La ilaha illa anta subhana inni kuntu min al-talibin, but the difficulty is still coming upon me. Whatever calamity I'm facing has not gone away. So Hazrat ji rahmatullah replied to him, maybe you didn't recite it thinking yourself to be a zalim. You didn't recite it thinking yourself to be a wrongdoer. So when we recite this ayah, this verse, it's called ayah al-kalima as well, we should recite it with this intention and thought that I am a zalim, I am a wrongdoer, and Ya Allah, you are the only one who I can turn to. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ وَنَجَّيْنَاهُ مِنَ الْغَمِ. That what did we do? We responded to him and we saved him from the distress. Allah says, وَكَذَٰلِكَ نُنْجِي الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And thus, we are the ones who save the believers from the difficulties. So we have to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincere prayers and conviction and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ayyub alayhi salam, same. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَيُّوبَ إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ أَنِّي مَسَّنِيَ الضُّرُّ وَأَنْتَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. And remember when Ayyub alayhi salam prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the difficulty has certainly afflicted him. And what difficulty was it? He lost everything. He had so much wealth, his family, till even his wife was deserted him. So, but what does he say to Allah? Ya Allah, some difficulty has fallen upon me. When his wife said to him, why don't you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for ease? What does he say? That all my life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted me ease. Now for 8-9 years, I am going through the difficult phase. What is that in comparison to what ease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me before? But today, kuch bhi thoda sa kuch ho jaye hame, aise karte goya ki hame kabhi koi pareshani nahi hai. And something small happens, now like we are the ones who have suffered the most of all the difficulties. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاسْتَجَبْنَا لَهُ. We answered his prayers, فَكَشَفْنَا مَا بِهِ مِنْ ضُرٍّ, and remove the difficulty which had come upon him. وَآتَيْنَاهُ أَهْلَهُ. We gave him back his family. وَمِثْلَهُمْ مَعَهُمْ. And the like thereof with them. So he gave him even more than what he had before. رَحْمَةً مِنْ عِنْدِنَا. As a mercy from us. So whatever we do, whatever we get, is not because of what we are doing. No. Rather, it is because of the rahmah and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he says, وَذِكْرَ لِلْعَابِدِينَ. And as a reminder for the worshippers. It's a reminder for us. So we should not, so then should we not turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, دَعْوَاتُ الْمَقْرُوبُ. The supplications to be used by the one who is distressed. So what dua should we make? We should repeat this dua. Allahumma rahmataka arju. Allahumma rahmataka arju. That Ya Allah, your mercy is what I hope for. فَلَا تَكِلْنِي إِلَى نَفْسِ طَرْفَةَ عَيْنٍ. Do not leave me to myself for the blink of an eye. Even for one instance, do not leave me alone. Always be with me. وَأَصْلِحْ لِي شَانِي كُلَّهُ. And put all my affairs in order for me. All my affairs, Ya Allah, put them in order for me. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ. There is no God but you. There is none worthy of worship besides you. So Allahumma rahmataka arju. whoever attains any good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah will relieve him from affliction as well. In the Hadith al-Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَنَا عِنَّ ظَنِّ عَبْدِهِ فَلْيَظُنِّي خَيْرًا. I am as my servant thinks of me, then so let him think well of me. So if we think and have this firm yaqeen, Allah is the one who will remove difficulty, then definitely Allah will remove it. But if we have doubt, then how will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remove this difficulty from us? So Allah will do as we think of Him. Allah will do as we think of Him. So we have been surrounded by this COVID-19 from every side. And as a result, we see our lives. We are all constrained. We can't do what we are like prisoners. And throughout the world, we should hear people suffering from all around the world. They had nothing to eat, they had nothing to drink, they couldn't move, they had no freedom. Today, what do we see? Our freedom is also gone as well. But yet, alhamdulillah, Allah has given us so many bounties within our homes. Within our home, we are still eating, drinking, and being warm, having good clothes to wear. We are with our family members. Alhamdulillah, despite everything, yet we are in so much peace. So we should think of the positive rather than focusing on the negative. So we need to turn and become even more humble to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as a community as well, we should turn to Allah with dua, with all seriousness. Not just Ya Allah, but no, we all seriously sit down and take it as a matter of a seriousness, and that this is what I need to do, and with certainty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us success and remove us from this difficulty. And if we are wrong from anyone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what's going to happen? We are going to become frustrated. Because if we have recourse to anyone but Allah, this is like a mirage. What's a mirage? When you are in a desert and from far away at the edge, you see something shining and sizzling and you think, oh, I'm so thirsty, I haven't had water, I can see water from far away. When you go there, what happens? There's more water, it's just sand, and you see, oh, there is another one. This is called a mirage. So if we turn, if we have a recourse to anyone apart from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's like a mirage. You think, oh, success is here. This will make me give me relief from my difficulty. But when you turn to it, you see it's only a mirage and it's not there. Why? Because we have not turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that in Musnad Imam Ahmad, he says that whoever relies on something besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be left alone with it. So if you rely on some medicine, for example, if this medicine is what is going to cure me, then Allah will leave us to this medicine. But if we have the realization that Allah is the one who will cure me, it could be through this medicine, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give shifa. Like Musa alayhi salam, we mentioned it so many times. He asked Allah, Ya Allah, can I? He was ill. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him that eat from this plant. Next time he became ill, he went and ate from the plant, he didn't get shifa. He asked Allah why? Allah said, because the first time I put shifa in that medicine. So this is the trust and tawakkul we need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A famous saint, Abu Yazid Bistami rahmatullah alayhi, says that I lived among men for 40 years and I found them dead. Dead in terms of spirituality. For 40 years I lived among people and I found them dead. That they have no life and not knowing when they will be resurrected. That when they will gain back their spirituality. He says, I said Allahu Akbar four times. Now, where do we say Allahu Akbar four times? In Janazah Salah. So he says, I said Allahu Akbar four times, like the way we say to the deceased, because they were spiritually dead and I broke away from them. He says, I found them unable to do or undo anything. They can't do anything or they can't undo anything. They are unable to take life or unable to give life. Therefore, they cannot bring anything close or send anything away, and they cannot honor or humiliate anyone, and they cannot cause anyone any benefit or they cannot cause anyone harm. Rather, it is who does all this? It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then he read this few verses of poetry and he says, do not ask a favor of a child of Adam's, but ask him whose doors never close. Do not ask a favor of a child of Adam, but ask him whose doors never close. Allah is displeased if you do not ask him for your needs, and you will see that man is displeased when he is asked. जब अल्लाह से मांगते नहीं मांगते तो अल्लाह हमसे नाराज होता है. जब इंसान से मांगते हैं तो इंसान हमसे नाराज होता है. But Allah is the one that when you ask, when you don't ask Him, He becomes angry. And man is such when you ask Him, they become angry. So we should turn to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, who is the possessor of the power. Once a person came to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and said to him that who is Allah whom we have to turn to? So he came to the Prophet and says that who do you pray to? He asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that who do you pray to? So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, "Adru ila Allahi wahda." I pray to Allah subhanahu wa taala alone. Alladhi in masaka dhurran fad'awtahu. That who is distressed afflicts you and you pray to him, kashafa an, he alleviates. So what does he say? That I pray to Allah alone. And how does he describe Allah subhanahu wa taala? How does he explain to this person who Allah subhanahu wa taala is? Explains to him by saying that he is the one who, when you ask him, when you come upon a difficulty, what does he do? He alleviates the difficulty. And then he says, who, if you get lost in a wasteland and you pray to him, brings you back home? And who, if there is drought and you pray to him, grows plants for you? This is what answer we gave, describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And a poet says that have good patience, for relief is so close. وَصَبْرًا جَمِيلًا مَا أَقْرَبَ الْفَرَجَ. And then he says, he that obeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is the one who commands everything, will succeed, will survive. And he that who is true to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not be touched by any harm. And he who has hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have his hopes fulfilled. That's what the poet says. Ubayd ibn Abi Salim relates that he says, Ta'us came to visit me when I was dead. So he says that when he was ill, Ta'us came to him and to visit him. So he says, I said to him, then pray to me to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah rahman. So pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for me. So he said to him, then pray to Allah himself. Khud Allah se maango. And he said, for Allah is the one who answers the distressed one when he calls upon him. So I will make dua for you, that's fine. But you yourself also make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because Allah is the one who answers the du'as of those people who are distressed, who are going through a difficult time. Wahab ibn Munabbah, he says that I have read in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the first book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, by my might, if someone seeks refuge with me, and all that is in the heavens, and all that is in the earth, that turn against this person, I will make a way out for him. So there's no way out. Everyone, everything has turned against him. And who will make a way out for this person? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if someone does not seek refuge with me, I will make the earth swallow him from underneath his feet and make him fall down by letting him rely on himself. So if you rely on yourself, you don't turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will be digging your own grave and going further into the misery and agony and difficulty that you are that you are facing. Hafiz ibn Asakir, rahmatullah alayhi, he says that I used to hire a mule of mine for travelers from Dimashq, from Damascus to Zubaydah. He says, one day a person rode with me, and while we were riding, we came across a path which was like in a jungle, which wasn't a normal, it wasn't a main path, it was a untrodden path, meaning something which was not used, unused path. So this person said to him, take this way, it is shorter. So he says, I've never taken this road before. But he says, the stick is the shorter route, he insisted. So he says, we ended up taking this road. And we went through a very rugged and a deep valley. And we came to a place which had many, many bodies. And then he said to him, stop the mule now, I want to get off. So then he got off, lifted his garments, and took out a long knife. Took out a huge knife, and then he began to come after me. So he goes, I ran away and he began to chase me. And he caught me up. And I begged him that by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you can take the mule and all the road and anything you want, take it. But leave me alone and let me live. But he said to him, the mule is mine anyway already. All I want is to kill you. But the person says, I warn him about the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but he did not respond. So he says, I surrendered to him. But then I asked him for one favor, and I said, would you let me pray two rak'ah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He replied, be quick. So then he said, when I rose to pray, words failed me, and I could not remember a single letter of the Quran. You know, when we are going through a difficult time, so what happens? We freeze. Our mind doesn't work. We don't know what to do. So when if an accident, for example, you don't know what to do, or something happens suddenly to you, you know, in normal circumstances, you are so clever, your mind works really well. But suddenly, when something comes upon you in, you know, a difficult time, you froze and it says, I cannot even remember one word of the Quran. Subhanallah, that's how much terror he was going through. That's how much afraid he was. And then he says, I kept standing and I was perplexed and I was confused. And why? He urged me, kneel down and pray your salah. And then he says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused my tongue to say his words. Amma yujibu al-mustadra idha da'a wa yakshifu as-su'a wa yaj'alukum khulafa'a al-ardh a'lam ma'allah. The verse today before we say that is he Allah not the best one who responds to the desperate one when he calls upon him. And the rest of the ayah, then he says, all of a sudden a horse rider came from the valley with a small lance in his hand. He says with an arrow in his hand, and he shot it at the man and it hit him right in the heart. And he says, I clung to the horse rider and asked him that who are you? He said, I am the messenger of he, meaning Allah, who answers the distress when he calls upon him and who removes the evil. So he says, I took the mule and its load and returned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and returned to my journey safe and sound. This is the consequence of turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we have no other path. Frozen, don't know what to do. Even the Quran he knew, he didn't, he couldn't remember any of it. But then, because he had the deen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this verse he recited, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who brought relief. At the same time, we should never despair of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy, nor give up hope in the compassion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know that every day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in a state of glory. He relieves even the mushrikeen, the disbelievers from the hardships and agonies when they turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَإِذَا رَكِبُوا فِي الْفُلْكِ دَعَوُا اللَّهَ مُخْلِصِينَ لَهُ الدِّينَ فَلَمَّا نَجَّاهُمْ إِلَى الْبَرِّ إِذَا هُمْ يُشْرِكُونَ. That the mushrikeen, that when they when they were a ship, and this ship was struck by bad weather, and it was about to sink, they prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincere hope. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rescued them. So he says, but when Allah rescues them to the land, they begin to ascribe pardons to him. So even the mushrikeen in sincerity turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah removes them from the difficulty. So what about us Muslims? Those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we experience difficulty, if we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether openly or whether in secret, whether in adversity or whether in prosperity, will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not listen to us? Will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala not answer the hukum? So whenever people strengthen their faith in Allah, and whenever we reinforce our ties with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every matter, whether it's a big, large matter or small, and we have positive thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to our assistance. So the main thing is that we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and place all our matters in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ. And turn and give all your matters before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the further we go away from the Quran, the further we go away from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the more we'll be plagued by calamities and darkness. So we need to adopt religious means, and also we are permitted to use worldly means as well, which are permitted in Sharia to be relieved from our distress and difficulties. Because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, فَتَدَاوَوْا وَلَا تَدَاوَوْا بِحَرَامٍ. That use medical treatment, but not use anything unlawful. So whatever is jais, we can use that as well. But with intention, it is from who? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we also need to blame ourselves for our own problems as well. That we can't just say everything, we are being so well, so why is it upon us? No. Because sometimes our own actions face difficulties. Hafiz Ibn Rajab rahmatullah alayhi, he says that whenever the believer desperately awaits Allah's grace and despondently feels he will not be granted relief, after offering endless dua and supplications, and he sees no sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's response, then he must lay the blame upon himself and tell himself that you yourself, meaning himself, you are the cause of my affliction. If you are of any good, Allah will surely have responded to you. In one hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O Muhajireen, there are five things are such that you are involved in them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made dua. May Allah not cause you to be involved in them. Then the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will descend upon you. He says, the five things are, when the nation that is commonly involved in zina will become afflicted by plague and other such diseases that you are never heard of before. So we see this happening. And then the second one, those that cheat in measuring will be affected by poverty, hardship and oppression. You see that happening. Those that default in paying the zakat will be affected by drought. We see that happening. Had it not been for the animals, not a drop of rain would have fallen. Then so those that transgress the bounds of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they'll be overcome by the enemy. And we see that happening as well. As for those that legislate unjustly, they'll be involved in fighting amongst themselves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from all this. And then Shaykh further says that when we start to blame ourselves, that I am the cause of my own downfall. So he says, such a reproach to oneself is more cherished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than many acts of obedience, that it signifies the total sense of a servant's loneliness and subservience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his acknowledgement that he truly deserves the pride which he has been afflicted with, and that he is not worthy of seeing his invocation fulfilled. That you think that it is my cause, and because I am unworthy, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not accepting my du'as. So he says, consequently, the response of Allah is rushed and his plight is relieved, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all hearing and all respondent to those whose hearts bow in utter humility towards him. So like the Yunus alayhi salam, he accepted zalimeen. It's my mistake. I am the zalim, I am the oppressor, I am the transgressor. That ya Allah, I can only turn to you. So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala removed the difficulty. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the most. A poet says that no matter how long it takes, Allah's blessing will appear faster than a twinkling of an eye. هِيَ الْأَيَّامُ وَالْغِيَرُ وَأَمْرُ اللَّهِ يُنْتَظَرُ. Days pass and so do the lessons, and we wait for the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Are you desperate of seeing relief? Where then is your belief in Allah and destiny? And then it says, وَكُلُّ الْحَادِثَاتِ وَإِنْ تَنَاهَا فَمَوْصُولٌ بِهَا فَرَجٌ قَرِيمٌ. Allah's misfortunes, however severe, will surely be relieved soon. In the Surah Al-Mashr, Allah says, إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرَى إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرَى twice. After difficulty, there is ease. After difficulty, there is ease. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring about ease as well. And one or two points I'd like to mention, which Dr. Saab mentioned last week, is that we need to build our immunity up as well. So one is our spirituality, which we all spoke about. But also our physical and mental health is also very, very important for to increase the immunity in our bodies. So the important thing is that we should eat fresh food. Food which is cooked properly. So try avoiding cold foods or salads, sandwiches and stuff like that. Because this will help protect us from the virus and even other viruses in general. As the viruses, they will stay longer in cold places, cold and dry, like fridge and stuff like that. So have leafy vegetables, fruits in rich in vitamin C, also honey. Now also I mentioned Manuka honey is from New Zealand, the high grade, it's very, very good as well. Kalonji seeds, black seed oil, black seeds, and avoid cold water, cold drinks. So look after your diet properly as well. So heat your food up properly before eating and eat freshly cooked food. Number two, he also mentioned is the mental stress, that don't take psychological stress. Why? Because we've been in our homes all day, and because we are in a constrained environment, then we experience mixed emotions. So it's important that we don't stress too much, we don't get angry all the time, or take tension in our minds with everything. So we should not burden our mind unnecessarily, and because negative emotions, they can actually bring our immunity down. So negative emotions, they can bring our immunity down. So focus on what you can control and stay positive. And do lots of istighfar and lots of durood and turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring about his